Hi, thanks for joining me. This is Angie at Chicken Scratch, and this is the card we're making today. Okay, so this card is actually the card that I took to Hawaii for my swap. I made 26 of these using all of the new end colors, the brand new end colors that's going to be available June 2nd. And the one we're going to make today is actually this one. Okay, so that is the new watermelon color. And the supplies that you're going to need, this is 11 by 4 1/4, and I have scored it at 5 1/2 to form the card base. The next layer is Whisper White, and that measures 5 1/4 by 4. We're going to emboss that. And then the next layer is the watermelon again, and this is 4 by 3. And then I used the envelope paper. You might miss that in the catalog. You can use this paper to line your envelopes, but it was the only paper at the time that I could get that matched our new end color, so I thought it would be perfect for my swaps. And so this piece measures 2 7/8 by 3 7/8. And then I have my white piece here for all of my butterflies. We're using 2 stamp sets. Floral Wings, which is a hostess set in the brand new catalog. If you don't order enough to ever get hostess benefits, you might want to check out my Stamp Club online and Hostess Code Club. Both of those are clubs where you place a minimum order each month and you take turns being hostess. So that's one of that's the set. And then the Butterfly Basics is the other butterfly that you see here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and get my Stampin' Done so that I can cut these images out using the butterfly thinlets. So I'm going to stamp this first, and if I remember correctly, I think I needed the Stampin' Matte with this butterfly. Well, it looks pretty good. No, I missed a corner right there, but that's okay. It's not that big of a deal. And then for this greeting right here, the Just For You, that is in that same stamp set, and I went ahead and cut a strip that just measures 1/2 inch because we're going to be using one of the new punches. Okay, so now we're going to take the triple banner punch and we're going to pin at the ends of this. I need to trim it just a little bit more. Okay, so that part's done. We can set that aside. Now I'm going to get out the Big Shot so we can cut out these two using the framelits. Okay? So here's the Big Shot. Magnetic platform. Cutting pad. I'll place this down. And then we're going to cut out this small butterfly first. Okay, and now we're going to cut out the larger butterfly. And we're going to use a piece of wax paper over top to make sure we get a nice clean image. Okay, so here's our image, and it should, thanks to the wax paper, it should, all these little pieces should come out pretty easily. And then make sure you get rid of the wax paper. I think I only have one. Yep. Okay, now we're going to use the Texture Boutique. This one is retiring on June 2nd. I'm kind of sad about that. So we're using the Stylish Stripes embossing folder. I will probably continue to use it for embossing. You guys know you can use the Big Shot, but it's so much easier to use the Texture Boutique. Okay, so I'm just going to roll this through. Now we've got our Watermelon Wonder ribbon, and all I'm going to do is just put a strip of adhesive on the back, and I'm just putting this in the center. And I can't remember now if I mentioned that I'm going to be giving away the extra card fronts. I made some extras for the swap in Hawaii and left them in my room. So I have these four. I'll give away all four. They're card fronts only. But anyway, leave a comment on this blog post to enter to win. Okay. And same thing here. We're going to add this. And this layer is actually going to get popped up. So I'm just going to take dimensionals in each of the four corners. And I'm just centering this on here, okay? Okay, the other stamp set that we're using, it's almost invisible. It's called You've Got This. It's also going to be in the new catalog. And I'm going to be using the Watermelon Wonder ink again. Just stamp that. And then you're going to take your 1 1/4 circle punch. Just cut that out. And what we're going to do is attach this butterfly to that. So I'm actually going to attach it, or attach the butterfly using dimensionals, because I want to give it a little pop. I centered it right in there. And then this one we're just going to add with glue dots. Right on top. And then we're going to take just a strip of 3 and add that. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll add this piece first and just center it right here. And we're going to add a couple rhinestones. And then now for this part, we're just going to attach it to the card with a couple glue dots. And I like to bring the wings up. Okay, so there you have it. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot. Bye.